Friday, April 17th, 2009. This is your Daily Dose. All right, a lot of Earth weekend events going on. Make sure you take part this weekend. Also, don't forget, 420 picnic, Monday, all day long, Mountain Crest Park. I'll probably be there real early, and I'll probably stay all day. But we'll be out there. Just come out. You'll be able to recognize us. Don't forget, Jack Herrera, Emperor Wears No Clothes. Get the book. It's very important. It's the whole cannabis education that you'll need. It's like a cannabis college all in a book. Check it out. And then today, I want to address some issues about some of the emails, phone calls, behaviors. You know, I figure I would just put this out there because I put it on YouTube for the whole world to see. So I'm going to go ahead and I want to address some issues. I'm just going to hold up my little board that I made here. And basically what it says is, we are not lawyers. So everybody that's emailing us stuff about your pending court cases and things like that, hey, if you want to send me that information, great, but I'm not a lawyer, okay? It's up to you. Just know that I'm not a lawyer. Also, we are not doctors. Now, we work with doctors to set up appointments for patients and such, but that doesn't mean that you need to send us your entire medical history. If you have a question that you honestly want to know, in other words, does this qualify, I'll give you an answer. But you don't also have to come into the office and exposing scars and all that. Trust me, we believe you. We are not the police. I am a veteran of the United States Marine Corps. I did protect, serve, defend the Constitution of the United States of America against all enemies, foreign and domestic. I did my time, and now I've chosen to take on the benefits of the United States of America, and I run a nonprofit corporation. But I'm not the police. I'm also not DEA. However, this is what I do. This is what we at MCCNV do, the Medical Cannabis Consultants of Nevada. We absolutely, positively, and do diligently help qualified patients get legal in Nevada. That's what we do here. And we educate and inform Nevadans that we have a medical marijuana program. It does exist, it is legal. We have t-shirts if you want to come down and help us keep this thing going strong in the state. By all means, support us. We have t-shirts available. Yesterday's video, you can check back if you want to see what the t-shirt looks like. Also, don't forget, raffle tickets will still be available. They'll also be available the day of at the picnic for the, I haven't shown it in a couple days, so I'll go ahead and show it, for the two handheld aromatherapy vaporizer devices that will be raffled off at the 420 barbecue picnic. We also have some devices that we will be presenting to some of our more severely affected patients. Also, what else do we need to chat about? If you do come to the picnic and you bring a dish, once again, remember to bring a recipe card. Also, feel free if you want to bring chips or something like that. Every little bit helps. We're a grassroots organization, so we humbly accept any donation that helps us to continue to do what we do. We understand that it might not be something for everybody, and I want to address some things that have come to my attention, and it makes me understand even more that times are changing. I myself fell into this category. My wife wasn't that she was resistant to the idea of the effect cannabis had in my life. And it's good to see families coming in where one, you know, whether it's the father or the mother or a dependent, you know, a caring child or another friend, you know, they might not agree with everything because of just the way they've been raised to think and feel about cannabis. But they know on a human level, when it truly helps somebody, that they'll come in and support that decision. And I just want people to know that we understand that you might not agree, but the same as anything else, it was voted upon. It's here. We don't want to try to rub it in anyone's face or anything like that. We just want people to understand what we go through. I'm sure it correlates to something in your lives that is similar. You know, there's always going to be something that discomforts people on a human level. And for me, it's knowing that there's sick patients out there that can't produce their own cannabis, that really need it, and yet we don't provide safe access for patients. Licensed patients like myself would be more than willing to do whatever it takes to gain the approval of whoever can grant the approval for us to be able to do that. Help us do that. Help us educate and inform Nevada by telling everybody you know that Nevada has a program, but it's basically a grow your own. It just doesn't make sense. Some of the sickest patients can't grow their own. And the gray areas in the legal realms, it just makes it difficult. We're still trudging along. Don't get me wrong. Oh, we come in California. Don't get me wrong. We on the run. I'm letting you know that right now. But we still need all the help we can get. Anything we can do to help you learn about the program, read over the website, tell your friends, family, relatives, tell them all over the country. Because this is going to be an issue that becomes very, it already is huge, but it's becoming bigger and bigger by the day. And I'm just grateful to be able to play a role in it. Contrary to popular belief, I don't stand on the corner like a hippie and smoke joints. I defended my country. I've done what I've had to do. I've been a restaurant manager, a computer programmer, an odd job worker. I sold vacuum cleaners. I've done it all. You name it. I've been there and done that. Now, I understand what they mean when they say, when you truly find something that you love, it's not work. It's not. I hope that everybody that's watching this can find something that they truly have a passion for. And can extend yourself towards that passion. I'm blessed to be able to have done it. And the thing is this, people have to understand, I'll do whatever it takes for this. So when I'm out there selling t-shirts on a corner, it's because I really believe in what I'm doing. And although I care about people's opinions, sometimes you have to understand, you don't see what I see. And you can't judge me for what I've seen. So just let me do what I'm doing, and I promise I'll follow all the rules, all the laws, as best as we can, as long as people will work with us. But right now, this is what's important. You need to know this. And this was Friday, April 17th, 2009. Your daily dose.